show, and there's only one thing to say.
Colbert says he's been wanting Trump to say his name for the last year, so he wins. Colbert has now topped late night ratings for 14 straight weeks.
Mm. Well, it sounds like a weekend to get mom outside for sure to celebrate.
Yeah, maybe all 3 days, right? Just do a 3-day celebration. Mid-70s for today. Again, going to be a nice sunrise for you. Going to keep that sunshine around. Maybe take mom to dinner tonight. Do a little happy hour. I know, sorry about that. I'm getting a little dust off the desk here as I wait away. Yeah, it's going to be a beautiful one out there today. Changes come next week, though. I'll talk more about our storm chances in the next half hour.
All right, some great live views around the metro right now as the sun's coming up out there. Beautiful shot. You can see the sun coming up over downtown West Des Moines, the airport, and the Des Moines River there as well. We're back with more news, weather, and traffic to start your day.
At Viridian Credit Union, we've opened our 30th branch, and we want to celebrate with you. So we're offering 1.30% APR for the first 6 months on any home equity loan. With a rate this low, you can consolidate debt, fix up your home, or do just about anything. Even when your 6 months is up, our regular rates are still this low. And saving money is something we can all celebrate. Apply soon. Simply call, click, or stop by any Viridian branch.
Maytag knows it can be easy to forget you've got wet clothes sitting in the washer. That's why Maytag has the fresh hold option. It keeps clothes tumbly fresh in the washer for up to 12 hours. So the loads you forget will be ready when you remember.
Uh-oh.
Get 50 up to $700 in rebates and 36-month financing at Nebraska Furniture Mart.
Watching KCCI 8 News.
Right now, help wanted. How many open positions Des Moines police need to fill to make the city safer?
New information about one of the suspects in the Cedar Bridge arson investigation. What we learned overnight.
And Comey controversy. President Trump contradicts his administration on why he fired the FBI director.
Well, good morning and welcome back, everyone. I'm Elizabeth Klein.
And I'm Eric Hanson. As we start off this Friday, May 12th, this is going to be an awesome weekend, Riley. Sounds like it's only going to get better the next few days.
It is, yeah. In fact, if you like warm temperatures, you're going to love this week. And in fact, check out the sunrise this morning. This is one that you want to put in the books, maybe put on Facebook, Twitter. That's what I'm going to be doing. Waking up this morning, maybe having the coffee sitting on the deck before you head off to work. Great morning to do that. Chilly outside, though, for some of us. We're in the upper 40s right now, so you might want to grab that light jacket and the sunglasses before you head out. Northwest winds between 5 and 15 miles per hour. They're going to change more toward to a northeasterly direction between 5 and 15, so more of a light wind for today. As we take a look at your temperature forecast, again, we're starting off chilly in the 40s, but we'll end up in the upper 60s for your lunch hour. So again, this is going to be a great day maybe to sit outdoors with your friends, maybe do an outdoor lunch for your business meetings. This evening, maybe you want to head to dinner, sit outside for a nice evening, maybe grab that patio seat as we'll make it to the mid-70s for the afternoon temperature. It'll be a beautiful sunset for tonight under clear skies. Tomorrow morning, I don't think we'll start off as cool because winds will turn more southerly overnight tonight, and that's going to enable our temperatures tomorrow to make it to most likely the lower 80s. So looking ahead, again, enjoy the sun today. We warm up over the weekend. Mother's Day, talking about the mid-80s. Great day for her. Gets warm, though, by Monday. Could be pushing the 90-degree mark, and then we have a chance of storms. I'll talk more about the timing on those storms coming up in the extended forecast in just a few minutes.
Well, 14 homicides this year have rattled our community, and Des Moines police are working overtime to cover holes from vacant positions. KCCI's Alex Sachs is live at the police station this morning. And Alex, what positions does the department need to fill?
The Des Moines Police Department needs to fill sworn officers. They're looking to fill 26 positions right now. And Police Sergeant Paul Parizic tells us officers are stepping up to help fill the gaps.
We can work through it. Is everybody's the same. We can pick a person up and move them into another slot. We can take somebody from days and move them into nights. We can take somebody from detectives and move them down to patrol. We have the ability to adjust on the fly so that the community doesn't feel the impact.
And meanwhile, they're working to fill those positions. A class of 15 will soon be graduating from the police academy in June, with another academy class directly following that one. Three academy classes total just within the next 12 months. And Sergeant Paul Parizic tells us that they'll probably really start feeling that difference by December. That's when they really will start seeing those numbers. And he also says, with the help of Police Chief Dana Winger and the city of Des Moines, they have unfrozen six positions, and those will be added over the next 24 months. And that'll make a big difference as well. And coming up, we ask the tough question: is the lack of law enforcement seen a connection? Is there a connection with the increase of violence in the community? And we have that response coming up at 6:30. For now, back to you, Eric.
All right, Alex. Well, detectives over at the police department continue to search for answers in the shooting that killed Stephen Kim in front of his three children. That robbery happened 3 weeks ago tonight at an apartment complex west of Drake University. Police are still searching for information in this case and several other unsolved homicide cases around the metro as well. If you have any information that can help, call police or Polk County Crime Stoppers. That number is 515-223-1400. Now, the third teenager arrested in connection with the arson fire that destroyed the Cedar Bridge in Madison County is now back here in central Iowa. Olivia Bergman was just extradited from South Carolina back to the Madison County Jail. She's facing second-degree arson and first-degree criminal mischief charges. A teenager who has sexually abused three Iowa kindergartners has now been sentenced to 3 years at the state training school in Eldora. Logan McMurrin is 16 years old and committed the abuse in Marion over near Cedar Rapids. McMurrin is also going to be required to register as a sex offender. The kindergarten teacher from that classroom has pleaded not guilty to a misdemeanor. Diane Graham there will go to trial in July for failure to report the abuse.
The country's opioid epidemic is creating another kind of crisis. Hepatitis C is spiking across the U.S. because of unsafe needle use. The numbers are alarming here in Iowa as well. The state's Department of Public Health says that in 2000, there were 724 cases. In 2015, that increased to more than 2,000 cases. And local physicians are taking notice.
Over the past year, we've seen a number of referrals that have come in from drug rehab centers.
Well, next week, Polk County is sponsoring free hepatitis C screenings. You can get tested Wednesday morning during the Senior Fest and Health Fair. That's at the Iowa State Fairgrounds. Well, this morning, President Trump is explaining his decision to fire FBI Director James Comey. Reyes Bigner is here with that. And his version is different from what we have heard previously, right, Rhea?
Right, Elizabeth. The president's explanation is completely different. He told NBC News he was planning to fire Director Comey all along. The White House has said that Comey was fired over his handling of the Clinton email investigation, but the president called Comey a showboat and a grandstander and said he was going to fire him regardless.
Regardless of recommendation, I was going to fire Comey, knowing there was no good time to do it. And in fact, when I decided to just do it, I said to myself, I said, you know, this Russia thing with Trump and Russia is a made-up story.
The New York Times reported Trump asked Comey to pledge his loyalty. Comey declined but said he would be honest. The White House said the president would never suggest the expectation of loyalty. And work will soon begin on a new executive order to examine voter fraud. The president has repeatedly claimed that millions of people voted illegally in last year's election but has offered no evidence. A new video this morning from Oklahoma. Check out the ominous storm clouds from a rather large storm system. Texas, Arkansas, Missouri, and Kansas also getting hit by damaging winds and large hail. And check out the damage from those storms in Oklahoma. Several homes had their roofs ripped off. A garage was destroyed and a camper blew over, but the owners say that no one was hurt. The emergency management agency says nearly 60 homes in the area have damage. Well, heading over to Riley at 6:07. Luckily, we don't have any strong gusts. It was beautiful last night. Probably a good time for a walk, and it went into the morning this morning.
Yeah, exactly. It was the start of a beautiful weekend, and it's going to continue. In fact, Marlo White sent this picture in of all the pets there, an evening walk on the farm. Of course, everyone's enjoying the nice weather, including the pets out there, so why not do a dog park forecast for you? Happy strolls this morning. We'll have a nice sunrise, beautiful conditions. We'll be in the mid-60s by noon, so I think it's going to be sunny stretches out there. And then we're talking about some tail wagon weather as temperatures make it to the mid-70s for the afternoon high. Looking ahead into the week, and to give you a preview, tomorrow if you're heading to the farmer's market, it's going to be a gorgeous day once again. It really will start to warm up tomorrow as winds turn more southerly, so we'll be in the mid-60s already by 10 o'clock. By noon, when the farmer's market ends, already in the mid-70s, I think we'll make it to the lower 80s tomorrow, and then ahead for Mother's Day. The sunshine continues, but we really start to warm up mid-80s there for mom on Sunday. Even on Monday, we look at the chance of maybe close to 90 degrees, but things turn active next week with the chance of thunderstorms. I'll talk about that in the 8-day forecast coming up.
All right, thanks, Riley. Well, a new state law allows fireworks sales from June 1st through July 8th in Iowa and again around New Year's, but local governments can outlaw their use. In Ames, there's been an ordinance for the past 30 years banning fireworks within the city limits, but city leaders say that that could change at next week's meeting.
They might consider repealing the ordinance. They might keep the ordinance. They might change it. They might put safety regulations in.
Well, the assistant city attorney there tells KCCI if the city council decides to make any changes to that 30-year-old ordinance, there is still time for it to happen before the 4th of July. Well, just ahead, Mother's Day, it's right around the corner. Why flowers might be the right gift this weekend.
And saving money on your home. Three mistakes to avoid ahead this morning.
And at 6:09, taking a live look out to the roads, this is I-235 at Guthrie Avenue, moving right along for you this morning. Enjoy that sunshine as you're headed out to school and to work on this Friday. Looks like we're getting some backup in Grimes from East 1st Street going on to Highway 141 coming towards the metro. Keep that in mind as you're headed out. West Des Moines looks like it's also starting to pick up. I'll detail that out for you. 49 degrees, and Riley is going to break down the details of your sunny forecast. That's right after this.
This month is a rockin' at Dewey. We've got the inventory. We're ready to roll with America's Best. It's our Drive and Discover sales event with big Ram quad cabs for just $199 per month. We're transforming what a car dealership feels like just by treating you right. Dewey, we will rock you. Born here, raised here, we love it here in Ankeny.
Get amazing deals during the Hy-Vee Big Breakfast Sale, where you'll find breakfast food on sale throughout the store. Hy-Vee sliced bacon, just $2.98. Chobani Greek yogurt, only 88 cents. Orata potatoes, two for just $5 with Fuel Saver. General Mills cereal, four for only $8.88 with Fuel Saver. Get a free half gallon of Hy-Vee orange juice when you buy two Eggo products. And this Friday and Saturday only, the ultimate breakfast deal. Hy-Vee 18-count eggs for only 59 cents. Don't miss the Hy-Vee Big Breakfast Sale.
You want to change up one thing in your wardrobe, add color.
We have the nicest selection of colored gems that you're going to find anywhere in the Midwest.
They look incredible. They're the best that nature can offer.
We have fabulous pieces that go well for any occasion.
The centerpiece of any piece of jewelry is the gemstone.
The timeless piece that they can enjoy today, plus 20 years down the road.
Why pay more? Find amazing prices on Iowa's largest selection of furniture, mattresses, and accessories at Homemakers. Plus, your choice of free driveway delivery or 2 years no-interest financing. Get hot deals store-wide and online, like this Ashley sofa for $277. This leather Lazy Boy rocker recliner, just $399. It's the final days of free driveway delivery or 2 years no-interest financing. Going on now at Homemakers.
People are talking about the new Buick. With four fresh new models to choose from. And what are they saying?
Your new Buick is so cute.
Love the new Buick.
That's a Buick?
Sweet Buick.
Experience the new Buick.
See your Buick dealer and get nearly 4,000 total value on select 2017 Buick Encore vehicles in stock. Visit your select Iowa Buick dealer today.
Live captioning of KCCI News is brought to you by the Iowa Clinic.
When faced with a possible cancer diagnosis, you shouldn't have to wait for answers. The Iowa Clinic Women's Center believes in providing our patients peace of mind quickly. To schedule an appointment, call 875-9500.
This is Iowa's news leader. This is KCCI 8 News This Morning with Eric Hanson, Elizabeth Kling, meteorologist Riley O'Connor, and right now coverage with Rhea Spigner.
Check out this video that one of our viewers sent us of elk playing out at the pond at the Neil Smith National Wildlife Refuge out in Jasper County. They say they saw these young elk at the refuge, and well, that one kind of wants to play, yeah. But the other one said, no, around. Shaking his head. No, I'm good. You can go ahead and play.
Not ready for pool weather just yet.
Right. Yeah. Could be this weekend, though.
It could be. We're going to be pushing upper 80s soon.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. I think some of us might even hit that 90-degree mark there on Monday, so wow. A great weekend to be outdoors. Mm-hmm. Of course, you want to be safe, have the sunscreen, but yep. Maybe you're going to be playing in the water, the sprinklers, or maybe get the pool ready. It's going to be a gorgeous weekend to do that. Check out the sunrise for your Friday morning. You can actually get by with the light jacket this morning. Upper 40s right now. Have the sunglasses because it is going to be a bright commute wherever you're going this morning. A little bit of a northwest wind now between 5 and 10. It's going to switch to more of a northeasterly direction as we get to the afternoon. And gusts maybe up to about 15. So looking at a pretty light day for the winds out there. Current conditions right now waking up in the low 40s up north. This is where you're cooler areas. Fort Dodge 45. Carol, good morning to you. 45 degrees. Having a nice sunrise down in Lamoni at 47. So the metro area, the planner for today, again, wall-to-wall sunshine. Upper 60s by lunchtime, so great day to maybe sit outdoors if you're doing any kind of business deals today or have clients. Great day to get the patio seat, or maybe you want to wait till dinner. Temperatures will make it to the mid-70s for today. Average is 71, so it is going to be a gorgeous sunset. Maybe you want to get that patio seat for the sunset this evening. Here's your future cast. Again, for today, just going to stay quiet. There's just not much going on. High pressure and control, so the warm weather will continue over the weekend. So today, expect your temperatures to make it to the mid-70s for central Iowa. Northern Iowa, still in the mid-70s for you. Tomorrow, the wind will start to switch to more of a southerly direction. So if you're heading to the farmer's market, it's going to be a sunny day for you. Temperatures tomorrow will be approaching that 80-degree mark with that southerly wind coming in. So it's going to be a warm weekend on tap for you. Here's your forecast for today. Again, looking really nice out there. Low to mid 70s. Temperatures tomorrow bump it up to 81. Mid 80s there on Mother's Day, so a great day there. Monday will be the warmest day of the week. I think we're going to close out about 88 degrees. Slight chance of maybe a storm in western Iowa. Better chances of rain coming Tuesday night into Wednesday, and next week does look active Thursday into Friday with a chance of storms.
Well, like I said, Riley, it's going to be a good weekend for Mother's Day, and remember, it is this Sunday, so procrastinators, you better hurry up. You only have 3 days to get your mom something nice for Mother's Day. Flowers are always the most popular gift every year. Here are all the orders over at Bose and the Florist getting ready to go out from Des Moines. Some beautiful flowers there. Staff say they're getting really busy, and they say if you haven't ordered yet, you better do it soon.
People really don't understand the science of flowers and what they do. They really do make you feel better. They make you feel more creative. And even though that doesn't last, the feeling that flowers does, it just doesn't last. But it's definitely worth it.
You still have a few days until Mother's Day, but florists say get your orders in now so they can get ready for it. Well, when it comes to chocolates, that's another big gift for Mother's Day. We stopped by Chocolate Storybook over in West Des Moines, where they're also getting very busy, getting things ready for the rush. They figure chocolate is good for every kid's very first sweetheart, their mom. Well, also, the National Retail Federation says on average, people are spending $186 on mom. It's a big dollar amount for an average. That's about $14 more than last year. As you heard, flowers are the most popular. 69% of moms will get them. 56% will treat mom to dinner or lunch. But more money will be spent on jewelry, a whopping $5 billion across the country.
No pressure to anybody, right?
Exactly. Right?
To come through on that. Well, Wells Fargo is planning to cut $2 billion more dollars in the coming year. The company had already announced that it would cut $2 billion in expenses by the end of 2018, and now it says it'll cut another $2 billion by the end of 2019. Most of the savings will come from consolidating operations and also closing 450 branches. No word yet on how it may affect Wells Fargo operations here in central Iowa. And this morning, a major set of trade agreements between the U.S. and China. The new deal allows American companies to sell beef and natural gas in China. China will then be able to sell cooked poultry in the U.S. The new trade deal follows the president's meeting with China's president back in April. And stocks were down on Wall Street Thursday. The Dow Jones dropped 23 points. The Nasdaq lost 13. And the S&P dropped 5 points.
Well, we're focusing on money mistakes on KCCI 8 News this morning all week long. And our focus today is your home. The first misstep you might be making is buying too much house. Make sure that you include things like insurance and property taxes and any association fees when you're buying. Your mortgage total should be about 30% of your monthly income, so don't overbuy. Now, if you already own a house, make sure you have a rainy day fund available. That's about 6 to 12 months of your own income in a checking or savings account that you can access for an emergency, things like a new roof or anything that might pop up. And when it comes to your mortgage, try paying a little bit more every month. Those little extra payments can go a long way in the long run. After 30 years, they really add up on a mortgage.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Well, time is 6:18. We'll head over to Riley, but you want to get out of the house this weekend and enjoy these great temps.
Exactly. Yeah, temperatures are going to continue to warm through the weekend into the 80s. Probably a good idea to get that air conditioner checked out because some of us are probably going to be turning that on, especially as we get into the Sunday-Monday time frame. Today, looking really comfortable. Sunshine out there, 75 degrees. If you're traveling for Mother's Day, maybe heading to see Mom, the upper Midwest is just going to stay very quiet under high pressure. So here's your town-to-town forecast for today. Expect lots of sunshine. Anywhere you go, Adel, about 74 degrees, Ames mid-70s. Same for the metro area down to the south. Lamoni, you're having a beautiful sunrise this morning. Greenfield ending up about 72 to 75 degrees there for you. In Clarinda, warm day. Rockwell City, it's a great start for you there. Jacket weather now going to this morning, but again, you're going to end up in the mid-70s this afternoon. So great day to be outdoors. Clarion to Toledo, maybe heading out to dinner tonight. Bloomfield, looks like it's going to be a great day for you as you end up in the 70s as well. So like I mentioned, the air conditioner might be used this week, and temperatures will slowly warm. Lower 80s on Saturday for Mother's Day, mid-80s. Great day to be with Mom outdoors for you. And then Monday, this is where I think the warmest day of the week will approach. Some of us will get close to that 90-degree mark, where there's a slight chance of maybe a few isolated storms trying to develop in western Iowa. I think central and eastern Iowa will stay dry. You're going to have to watch that closely. Better chance to start to arrive Tuesday night into Wednesday, where we could be looking at the potential for maybe a few strong storms, and then it turns active into next week. Thursday and Friday looks like the chance of thunderstorms will be there, with temperatures still in the lower 80s both Wednesday and Thursday, and even Friday right around 78 degrees.
All right, looks good. Thanks, Riley.
Looks like you're going to need the sunglasses if you're heading east this morning on your commute. Sun's out.
Oh, yeah, sunglasses and jams. Look at that. I-235 at 42nd Street moving right along for you this morning. And, yeah, the sun is up and out. So good morning. That's a good wake-up call. Don't forget, there is construction south of the metro towards Indianola. Highway 65 between Highway 69 and Highway 92. Now, that's confusing, but it's going to dwindle down to a single line of traffic until about 6 p.m. tonight. That's part of your morning. Can you keep that in mind? You can see some slowdown already happening along Highway 65 around Indianola. Some other slowdowns to keep in mind across the metro. West Des Moines at Army Post Road, it looks like we have some slowdown. At Park Avenue, it looks like we have some slowdown. Luckily, not Southwest 63rd Street right before you get on that freeway. Highway 69 as well, getting some action, it looks like. And it looks like we have an accident that just popped up in Altoona. I'll be able to detail that out for you in just a second. Just popped up on my screen. Keep that in mind as well as you're headed out. Your Des Moines Mobile Speed Unit's 1900 Merklin Way clocking southbound traffic is going to be your first one. You'll find another right here at 4100 University clocking eastbound traffic. 2700 MLK Junior Parkway clocking southbound near Highway 69. Two from Polk County, they're both near Sailorville Lake today. 4200 Northwest 94th Avenue, and your last one to look out for, 7200 Northwest 26th Street.
Coming up, we'll head to Washington, where the president explains his decision to fire the head of the FBI, why his version seems to differ from other statements we've been hearing from the White House.
And we're watching the world from a unique perspective live this morning. This is inside the International Space Station right now, where Iowan Peggy Whitson is getting ready to start the 200th spacewalk on the International Space Station. But a live view from way above the Earth, that spacewalk starts at 7 a.m.
Very cool. And keep your TV on KCCI later today. Star of Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2, Chris Pratt, is on today's Ellen show. Find out why bedtime is such a big deal for his son and the crazy diet that he follows for his movie roles. That's at 4 here on KCCI. And some great shows tonight as well. Undercover Boss, Hawaii 5-0, and 48 Hours NCIS.
In Iowa, hard work gets rewarded. And we don't quit until the job is done. At KCCI, it's our job to inform you of what's happening right now.
We begin with breaking news.
To tell you about the issues you care about. To hold the powerful accountable, investigating to uncover the truth. We keep you up to date on the latest developments on all your devices. Whenever, wherever. Trust KCCI, Iowa's news leader.
This month is a rockin' at Dewey. We've got the inventory. We're ready to roll with America's best. Choose from over 300 brand new Dewey Ford F-Series trucks, a leader for over 40 years, over 100 new Dewey Ford Focus Infusions, over 60 2017 Dewey Escapes. Dewey rocks with service and rolls with selection. Born here, raised here, we love it here. Dewey Ford in Ankeny. Get out on the lake and get fishing with Mills Fleet Farm. Right now, Bright Start Marine Batteries start at $48.99 with exchange. Buy select sizes of Science Diet or Hill's Ideal Balanced Pet Foods. Get an added bonus, a free $10 gift card. Reduce harmful mineral buildup with Morton Clean and Protect Water Softener Pellets. 40 pounds, $5.99. And smoke your favorite foods like a pro with a Masterbuilt Digital Smoker. $299.99 at Mills Fleet Farm.
Your word is ultimate.
Could you use it in a sentence?
Subway's new Ultimate Hot and Hearty Ham and Cheese Sandwich features double the ham and double the cheese for double the bold, hearty flavor.
U-L-T? Hey, where's everybody going?
Toyota of Des Moines is celebrating you for Customer Appreciation Month. Now during the Toyota Time sales event, you'll get our biggest savings. Lease a new Camry SE, just $179 a month. Or a new Highlander LE, just $289 a month. Plus, with a job making $350 a week, we want to get you approved.
Is that going to happen often?
Yep.
Good.
Toyota of Des Moines, the six-state region's number one Toyota destination.
It's our business to have exactly what you're looking for.
We told you earlier this morning about President Trump's interview with NBC News, in which his account of the firing of FBI Director James Comey differs from his administration's. Well, one source of controversy, a dinner the president had with Comey. Washington reporter Nicole Killian joins us live from our bureau this morning. And Nicole, what else can you tell us about this dinner?
Well, Eric, in that NBC News interview, President Trump said that Comey asked to keep his job. He also suggested that Comey requested the dinner, although some of Comey's associates reportedly dispute that. In the meantime, there is a story that was published late yesterday by the New York Times citing a different account of this dinner by James Comey through some of his associates. According to those associates, they claim that Comey denied pledging his loyalty to the president, and did say that he would always be honest with him, the president not really addressing that loyalty pledge in the NBC interview. The White House also disputing that New York Times account.
Well, Nicole, there are also differing accounts as far as the firing itself of Comey. Any explanation from the White House about that?
Well, as you know, President Trump has explained now that he was planning to fire James Comey regardless of any recommendations he got from the attorney general or deputy attorney general, which cited Comey's handling of the Clinton email investigation. Now we're learning through the president that really was the Russia investigation that drove his decision-making. And the White House, however, had been saying otherwise all this week, the deputy press secretary explaining that she had not directly asked President Trump about when he made that decision about firing Comey until right before yesterday's press briefing. But certainly a lot of folks were out there well before the president, including the vice president.
And you mentioned the deputy attorney general there, Rod Rosenstein, another official at the center of all this. He wrote the Comey memo. What's his take been?
Well, he is reportedly upset over the way the White House has handled Comey's dismissal, particularly their emphasis on the memo that he wrote to justify Comey's firing, although he does deny reports that he threatened to quit his job over it. He was on Capitol Hill yesterday making a surprise appearance. He met with the head of the Senate Intelligence Committee. While we understand that the top Democrat in the Senate, Chuck Schumer, actually wants Rosenstein to brief all senators on Capitol Hill next week. Eric?
We'll keep watching it, and we appreciate your coverage from Washington, D.C. Nicole?
Well, we're working on more news stories for you after 6:30. Iowa researchers have an exciting project that's out of this world. And in Iowa's Couples Compassion takes them around the globe. Plus,
more officers needed as the community starts to notice an uptick in violence and there's an increased call for services. Meanwhile, Des Moines police officers are working overtime to fill the gaps. What's next for the department?
And we're kicking off this Friday with a sunny start. We'll continue that sunshine through the weekend with a bit of a warm-up. I'll detail the forecast coming up after the break.
Ring the bell. Bell Brothers Heating and Air Conditioning. To protect your kids. Culligan asks, have you thought about the safety of your home's drinking water?
This week at Charles Gabus Ford on the Merle Hay Auto Mile, you can save 25% off MSRP on select new in-stock Fords, like brand new 2016 Ford F-150 trucks or sporty new 2017 Ford Fusions. Drive a 2017 Ford Fiesta for as little as $10,999. And Charles Gabus Ford proudly offers first responders an additional $1,000 in savings. Plus, get $5,000 minimum for your trade toward the purchase of any select new in-stock Ford. So stop in today and let's make a deal at Charles Gabus Ford.
Right now, take an extra $10 off Extreme packages and get TV and internet that really work together. Experience the power of TiVo with live TV streaming throughout the house, up to 380 TV and music channels, and free on demand. Plus, get download speeds up to 200 meg with matching Wi-Fi speeds and unlimited nationwide calling. Extreme packages with TiVo start as low as $69.98 a month for a year. Call 800-SIMPLIFY today.
It's not hard to have fun when you know the magic words. Start planning your next trip to the water park capital of the world. Go to wistdells.com and get your free vacation guide.
Why put another crossover on a road already filled with them? Why give it headlights like jewels, a body that feels sculpted? Why give it an interior or even the dash is cut and sewn by hand? It's simple. You can build a car or you can build a Cadillac. Get this low-mileage lease on this Cadillac XT5 from around $399 per month. Visit Willis Cadillac in Des Moines for this attractive offer or online at williscadillac.com.
Don't wonder. Get a test from the Culligan man. If our lab finds contaminants, Culligan has technology to reduce lead, arsenic, nitrates, E. coli, and more.
Get great-tasting, clean, clear drinking water for $13 a month.
Hey, Culligan man.
The most watched morning news in central Iowa. This is Iowa's news leader. This is KCCI 8 News This Morning.
Officer openings at a time when Des Moines seems more violent than ever. Police say they need to hire dozens more officers.
Leaving home, an Iowa couple talks about why they felt compelled to travel around the globe to help Syrian refugees.
And the greatest gift, an Iowa woman is about to become a mother after doctors told her it wasn't possible.
Well, all new stories this half hour here on KCCI. Welcome back on a beautiful morning. I'm Eric Hanson.
And I'm Elizabeth Kling along with Rhea and Riley. Yeah, beautiful morning to start with and more beautiful weather to come.
Keep it coming.
Yeah, definitely. And just in time for Mother's Day weekend, right? Beautiful start up there, Lake Rathbun. Check that out. Oh, what a gorgeous shot. It's a little chilly in some areas. You can buy with that light jacket. 46 right now. up in your area, or I should say southeast. Northwest wind at 6. Now, the wind will stay from the north between about 5 and 15 miles per hour today. It's going to switch to more of a northeasterly direction as we get into the afternoon. But check out this view here downtown. I mean, this is just a gorgeous shot. 49, so we're starting in the upper 40s for a good part of the state with a northwest wind at 8. Now, current conditions, the coolest there up to the north. Outgoing on one of the cooler spots. 41, mid-40s there for you in Fort Dodge, and waking up with a nice sunrise there for you in Lamoni. So your hour-by-hour forecast for this morning, expect a lot of sunshine. We'll be in the upper 60s already for the lunch hour. 68 degrees expected. There's your northeast wind between 10 and 15. It'll be a gorgeous sunset for this evening. Maybe you want to have dinner outside tonight on the patio. Nice night for that. Skies will stay clear overnight tonight. Our wind will change to more of a southerly direction, and that is going to enable the warm-up coming in over the week. And in fact, I'll tell you how warm we get, including the Mother's Day forecast coming up.
Well, new on 8, the Help Wanted sign is out at the Des Moines Police Department. They're working overtime to try to fill holes left by open positions. KCCI's Alex Sachs is live over at the police department this morning. And how many do they need to hire, Alex?
Oh, right now, Eric, they need to hire 26 sworn positions. And to paint the picture of just how many officers that is, that's an entire watch, or think of a day's worth of officers working the streets. But when we spoke to Sergeant Paul Parizic with the Des Moines Police Department, he says officers are committed to their job, and in fact, many are working overtime to help fill some of those gaps. And he says there's some good news on the horizon. They have an academy class that's graduating at the end of June that has 15 members in it, and then they have a total of 3 academy classes that'll be done within the next 12 months. So that's some really good news there. He also says that Police Chief Dana Wingert, along with the help of the City of Des Moines, have unfrozen 6 positions within the department, and they're looking to add in those positions in the next 24 months. Another big positive for them. As they continue to work, what a lot of people in this community have noticed is an increase in crime. Now, we asked Sergeant Parizic the tough question. Is the lack of law enforcement officers in the department, you know, working overtime, have any connection to the increase in violence? His short answer, no. The long answer, yes, police presence is a deterrent, but these crimes are happening. This is a trend we're seeing not just in our community, but in communities across the country.
It definitely puts a strain on our resources. The volume of calls that we're handling has gone up. Obviously, we're at a very high number of homicides this year. That puts a significant strain on our detective bureau. But we always plan for the worst case scenarios and hope for the best. But the public generally will not feel the impact or see the difference.
And that's where he says the commitment of the officers comes in, really making sure that the community doesn't feel the impact of the need for more officers and they do feel safe and secure. In Des Moines, Alex Sachs, KCCI News, Iowa's News Leader.
All right, Alex. Well, one of the cases police have been busy with, the murder of Stephen Kim 3 weeks ago tonight. Kim was shot and killed outside University Terrace Apartments at 3500 University on April 21st. Police say that was a robbery gone bad, and it was particularly shocking to them because police say the shooting happened right in front of his children. Police say there were 4 suspects possibly in that case, but they still haven't made any arrests.
We've learned that the 3rd teenager charged in the Cedar Bridge fire is now back in Iowa. Olivia Bergman was extradited to Madison County from South Carolina, where she'd been going through Marine basic training. Investigators say she left Iowa the day after she helped 2 friends set fire to the covered bridge last month. 17-year-old Alexander Hoff and 18-year-old Joel Davis are also charged in that case. This morning, there seems to be a split in Congress as to whether a special prosecutor should investigate Russian meddling in the 2016 election. Reyes here with the latest on that.
Elizabeth, President Trump's firing of FBI Director James Comey has both Democrats and Republicans questioning the timing. But many Republicans do not agree with Democrats' calls for a special prosecutor, pointing to the investigations already underway in the Senate and FBI. Iowa's Attorney General has joined 19 others across the country in calling for a special prosecutor. The request went to Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein and states this will be the only way to restore public confidence. Meanwhile, work will be getting underway to determine the amount of voter fraud in the 2016 election. President Trump issued an executive order creating a commission to investigate his so far unfounded claim that millions voted illegally. A recent study examining 14 years of elections in the entire country found only 31 cases of potential voter fraud. A new video just in, a big scare on a United Airlines flight in Texas. Not snakes on a plane, but a scorpion. United says the Scorpion crawled out of a passenger's clothing as it was about to take off. The crew quickly cleared the plane. No one was stung. United arranged a new aircraft, and all the passengers got a free meal.
Well, looking ahead, today an Iowa sailor will finally be laid to rest 75 years after his death.
It was an honor to have served, and he gave the most. So, that's it.
Remains of Fireman First Class William H. Kennedy arrived at the Des Moines Airport Thursday. Kennedy was a Tatonkin native who died in the attack on Pearl Harbor. His remains were just recently identified. A funeral and burial will be held in his hometown in northern Iowa today. He will be laid to rest beneath a gravestone his mother had made for him years ago. Also ahead today, one of the candidates for governor in 2018 will be speaking with Iowa reporters. Nate Bolton has announced that he is running for the Democratic primary, and he'll be announcing some key endorsements today. Bolton is one of a growing field of candidates who want to challenge Republican Lieutenant Governor Kim Reynolds. She will soon be taking over for Governor Branstad when he leaves for China. Also running in 2018, Democrats Fred Hubbell, Rich Leopold, Andy McGuire, John Niederbach, and Independent Brent Roskey.
More news stories this morning. An Iowa couple did what very few are willing to do. They traveled to Jordan to help Syrian refugees. Ethan and Bethany Anderson of West Liberty say they couldn't just stand by and watch anymore. So for 10 days, they helped Syrian refugees in Jordan. The couple had the chance to visit the homes of some refugee families, and they gave out household supplies that they had packed inside four suitcases.
So when we went to families' homes, we were able to actually give out a lot of those things, and that was really fun to see. The kids were so excited to get a doll or a little car.
Bethany and Ethan say there's still a lot of need, though, in Jordan. They've created a website where they are still collecting donations.
Well, scientists at the University of Iowa are very excited these days. Listen carefully to the reason why. That kind of muffled sound is the Cassini spacecraft orbiting Saturn between the planet's rings. An Iowa scientist designed the instruments that Cassini is using. One scientist says one of their tests involves studying radio waves outside the atmosphere. That's big.
Oh, very cool. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, ahead against the odds, a baby born to a Nebraska mother with Zika. Your first look at her incredible story.
Yeah, plus, an Iowa woman hopes to be a mom by Mother's Day. Her story straight ahead in the Morning Buzz.
And speaking of Mother's Day, we begin that warm-up. It's going to be a gorgeous weekend for mom, but changes are in the forecast. I'll talk more about that in the 8-Day coming up here in just a few minutes.
Weather powered by Wyckoff Heating and Cooling for peace of mind under your roof.
Comfort for your family. Are you feeling it? Rheem, the new degree of comfort.
Wyckoff's for peace of mind under your roof.
Go to wyckoffcomfort.com.
Greg Young Chevrolet of Norwalk. Drive a used car for just $199 a month with just $99 down. Financing made easy for you. Save big on our selection of used cars. Just $199 a month and $99 down.
$199 a month for cars.
Greg Young Chevrolet of Norwalk. Fast, fun, and friendly.
Don't miss Homemakers Mattress Madness Sale. Store-wide and online. Find everything you need for a better night's sleep with Homemakers Free For All event. With the purchase of any Serta Perfect Sleeper or Sealy Posturepedic mattress set, $5.99 or more, you get free delivery with free bed removal, a free bed frame, a free memory foam pillow, and a free sheet set. It's the Mattress Madness Sale. Store-wide and online, going on now at Homemakers.
Tired of sinus pain and pressure? Consider a simple procedure from ENT Clinic of Iowa.
Balloon sinuplasty changed my life.
Contact the ENT Clinic of Iowa, your sinus center of excellence.
I couldn't be happier. You should take a look because it might change yours too.
Swedish Fish are a unique fish-shaped candy. You know what else is unique and fish-shaped? Say, it's Sweden. Obviously. Swedish Fish, they're Swedish-ish.
Oh, good. good Friday morning, everyone. This is what it looks like outside. Whitney sent this picture in of West Des Moines. Beautiful sunrise there. In the distance, you could see the moon. Gorgeous shot there. Thanks, Whitney, for sending that in. Ames, you're starting off a little chilly this morning, but it is bright. 44, you get by with a jacket this morning. Gonna have to have sunglasses, too, so expect a lot of sunshine for today. Maybe you're traveling for Mother's Day, getting out of town. Expect a sunny sky. Temperatures will end up above average, ending up in the mid-70s. Lots of sunshine expected south and west Corning, ending up in the mid-70s as well. Clarinda, about 74 to 76 up there. Pocahontas and Algona, you're starting off chilly this morning, but you're going to have a warm day. Even in Jefferson, making it to around 74. North and east, beautiful day there for you in Marshalltown. It's going to be a sunny kickoff to the weekend. Gorgeous day there for you in Centerville. Lower 70s there. We are going to see some changes coming in the forecast. Gets warm over the weekend, but then we have a chance of thunderstorms next week. More on that coming up after the Morning Buzz.
Well, Riley, we have a couple of very special deliveries to show you in the Morning Buzz. This is Amy Elena. She was just born Tuesday morning in Omaha to a mother infected with the Zika virus. Mom Evelyn Suastegui is Nebraska's first reported mom to be with Zika. Doctors say the baby doesn't show any signs of having Zika-related complications, which experts believe actually happens about 90% of the time.
Sometimes the first thing we think about is the worst, but we never think about the good. And I went for the good my whole pregnancy, and thankfully it's going that way.
Can you imagine over the last 9 months how nervous she was? You know, you have Zika, you don't sure about the child. Well, the family is now home from the hospital just in time for Mother's Day, a good way to celebrate.
Yeah. Thank goodness it all turned out okay.
Definitely.
Well, now to Dubuque, a woman is hoping that her baby will arrive by Sunday on Mother's Day. Christina Jennings says that she's long dreamed of becoming a mother, but after four open heart surgeries and a pacemaker, her doctors told her, don't get pregnant. Well, Facebook helped her find a woman who was willing to carry a baby for her for no charge. That woman, Beth Schwartz, also lives in Dubuque. She said she just wanted to help make Jennings' dream come true.
A lot of people struggle and are ashamed of infertility or ashamed that they can't carry their own baby, but it's something that needs to be talked about.
Well, Jennings says that she also looked into adoption, but it wasn't an option due to her terminal heart condition. And at last check with the family last night, no baby yet, but they say things are progressing. Mm-hmm. So yeah. Hopefully it'll arrive in time.
Of like social media doing some good.
Some amazing things.
Timing can work out right for Mother's Day, too.
Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. And we have another picture to show you, too, this morning. This is from the Iowa DNR. Check out these morel mushrooms.
Huge,
right?
Oh,
wow. I mean, they are called what you call Bigfoot morels. Yeah. Now, they are found in southern Iowa, and the DNR says when these show up, it's a sign that mushroom season is wrapping up. But I tell you what, that's a meal right there.
Going out
yeah,
with a bang.
I guess so. Well, heading out live now, Riley, to be a great weekend out there, sounds like.
Definitely. Look at that sunrise this morning. A gorgeous shot. We get to have warming conditions over the weekend. We have to turn those air conditionings on. I'll detail the forecast coming up.
Greenhouses. For over 110 years, a satisfied gardener is a good gardener.
It's Yonkers' biggest one-day sale this Saturday with a preview day Friday. Save up to 60% store-wide and shop over 225 bonus buys all day Friday and Saturday. Shop in-store and online. Yonkers, your store, your style.
Toyota of Des Moines is celebrating you for Customer Appreciation Month. Now during the Toyota Time sales event, you'll get our biggest savings. Lease a new Camry SE, just $179 a month. Or a new Highlander LE, just $289 a month. Plus, with a job making $350 a week, we want to get you approved.
Is that going to happen often?
Yep.
Good.
Toyota of Des Moines, the six-state region's number one Toyota destination.
It's our business to have exactly what you're looking for.
I have asthma, one of many pieces in my life. So when my asthma symptoms kept coming back on my long-term control medicine, I talked to my doctor and found a missing piece in my asthma treatment with Breo.
Once daily Breo prevents asthma symptoms. Breo's for adults with asthma not well controlled on a long-term asthma control medicine, like an inhaled corticosteroid. Breo won't replace a rescue inhaler for sudden breathing problems. Breo is specifically designed to open up airways to improve breathing for a full 24 hours. Breo contains a type of medicine that increases the risk of death from asthma problems and may increase the risk of hospitalization in children and adolescents. Breo is not for people whose asthma is well controlled on a long-term asthma control medicine, like an inhaled corticosteroid. Once your asthma is well controlled, your doctor will decide if you can stop Breo and prescribe a different asthma control medicine, like an inhaled corticosteroid. Do not take Breo more than prescribed. See your doctor if your asthma does not improve or gets worse.
Ask your doctor if 24-hour Brio could be a missing piece for you.
Learn more about better breathing at mybrio.com.
Whatever you're cooking up, we've got just what you need for it. Because at Fairway, we do groceries best. This week, stock up on Ragu Homestyle Pasta Sauce. It's only $1.98. Serve it hot or cold. Lipton Tea is 2 for $5. Complete your dessert with Breyers or just have it on its own. It's just $3.79. Ben & Jerry's ice cream, Klondike bars, and Talenti gelato are 2 for $7. And for more savings and recipes, visit fairway.com.
It's Yonkers' biggest one-day sale this Saturday with a preview day Friday. Save up to 60% store-wide and shop over 225 bonus buys all day Friday and Saturday. Shop in-store and online. Yonkers, your store, your style.
A good Friday morning, everyone. This is the way you want to start your week, and on a bright note like this, check out the sunrise this morning when you wake up. 49 right now, so yeah, a little chilly. Northwest wind at 8. The wind will switch to more of a northeasterly direction this afternoon from about 5 to 15, so if you have outdoor plans, maybe working in the yard today, we're not looking at a real windy day, but definitely need the jackets up north, especially out going to Fort Dodge. 45 for those who feel it's a little chilly. Grinnell around 46, slightly warmer down to the south of Tumwater. You're having a nice sunrise this morning, too, at 48. So the Metro Planner for today, continuing to warm up through the afternoon. You have plans to be outdoors maybe for lunch or even dinner. It's going to be a gorgeous day to do that. Upper 60s already by the lunchtime. Great evening to grab the patio seat if you are heading out to dinner to kick off your Mother's Day weekend. Looking ahead, again, we're going to continue the sunshine through the weekend. Tomorrow, great day for the farmers market. We'll end up in the lower 80s tomorrow. Mother's Day, we're going to end up in the mid-80s, right about 85 degrees. We'll continue that sunshine. Now, next week starts to get a little bit active. We do have a slight chance of maybe a storm coming in on Monday in western Iowa. Monday will be the warmest day of the week. I think we'll approach anywhere from about 88 to 90 degrees. And then coming in Tuesday night, we have better chances of storms continuing through the end of next week. So next week, like I mentioned, we'll get active, especially in the middle part of the week. So future cast for today, again, staying quiet. Gorgeous day to be doing anything outdoors. Have the sunscreen handy. Again, the sun's going to be bright out there and strong. 73 by about 6 o'clock. And then temperatures tonight won't be as cool tomorrow morning waking up. The reason why is because the wind will turn more southerly, so that's going to enable our temperatures to really bottom out in the lower 50s, I think, for most of us. Tomorrow, again, if you're heading to the farmer's market, it'll be a nice sunny day for you. Maybe grab your favorite drink, go after the lemonade or maybe the ice cream there at the farmer's market as you're getting fresh veggies. Tomorrow afternoon, temperatures will top off in the lower 80s. And then Sunday, there you go, Mother's Day, 85 degrees. Warmest day of the week will be Monday, 88. Again, a slight chance of a storm western Iowa. Tuesday night into Wednesday, could be looking at potentially some stronger storms. And then it stays active to end the week. Thursday and Friday, we're going to have the chance for those thunderstorms also with temperatures in the lower 80s on Thursday. And then Friday, about 78 degrees. So really, just a great weekend for Mother's Day. If she has any plans outdoors, like, you know, parents like to do. My mom always liked to plant flowers. Maybe you're doing that with your mom out there. Great day to do it.
Absolutely. Great weekend to do it. Thank you.
All right. Well, let's head over to Rhea, see how our Friday morning drive is going. Yeah, it's going. This is I-235 at MLK. The sun already up and shining as you head out to school and to work. So enjoy that morning commute. Grab the sunglasses and just enjoy it. We do have something that looks like literally just cleared up about 2 seconds ago, but there was a serious accident on 8th Street in Prairie Meadows or near Prairie Meadows. So you want to keep that in mind. It still might be there or clearing up. Again, that just left my screen just now. Things to keep in mind as you're headed out, Hickman Road right near 100th Street, starting to get some backup in both directions. Otherwise, we're doing good across the metro. Your Des Moines mobile speed units for the day, 1900 Merklin Way, clocking southbound traffic. You'll find another right here at 4100 University, clocking eastbound traffic, and another at 2700 MLK Junior Parkway, clocking southbound right near Highway 69 and Scott Avenue. Checking in on your drive times, Aiken to downtown, you're looking at 11 minutes. Indianola to downtown, 26. Adel, 24. And Newton to downtown is a smooth 30 minutes. News to go is next, a fast blast of the news you need to know, making the streets safer in Des Moines, why Clive police need your help, and Stephen Colbert responds to President Trump. That's next.
Ahead here on CBS This Morning, Jeff Begays has new details about President Trump's interactions with former FBI Director Comey. And we'll check in on the Mount Everest climbers we've been following who are taking another shot at making it to the top. See you at 7.
Hey, guys. guys and gals, announcing Slumberland's throwback pricing. Get up to 69% off. Take a spin on this leather Lazy Boy, just $4.96. Grab this sofa for just $4.34. Throwback pricing. And only at Slumberland. It's a good life.
Hi. Welcome to Come and Go. You look thirsty. Excuse me. You know, we have a really large fountain area over there, too.
Beat the heat this summer at Come and Go with thousands of drink choices at every store. Come in for more refreshing deals like any size drink for just $1. Come and Go, where and means more.
Thanks.
To enjoy life indoors during Iowa's hottest months, your home's temperature needs to stay comfortably steady. For over 110 years, Logier Heating and Cooling has been keeping Central Iowans happy with a customer satisfaction rating of 98%. For even more happiness, right now Logier can save you over $3,000 in rebates on a new high-efficiency Dave Lennox signature system. To enjoy your home and everything you do in it, call Logier. We make you happy inside.
This is what precision looks like, helping you see what's hard to see, thanks to Terrain Denali's Side Blind Zone Alert that uses radar to watch your blind spots. So it's true, Mom does have eyes in the back of her head. The 2017 GMC Terrain Denali with Forward Collision Alert, Lane Departure Warning, Rear Cross Traffic Alert, and Side Blind Zone Alert. Step up to GMC and get nearly $4,500 total value on select 2017 Terrain SLE2 vehicles in stock.
Visit your select Iowa GMC dealer today.
John wants a man cave. Liv wants a bigger kitchen. Chris and Courtney want out of their apartment. Real bad. Iowa Realty agents have buyers who are waiting for you. Yes, waiting. Our specialty is connecting you with them, selling your home quickly, and getting you top dollar. Plain and simple. That's why 97% of customers recommend us to their friends. Thinking about selling your home? Consider it sold with Iowa Realty.
I just got the best night's sleep on this Beautyrest mattress. This is cause for celebration.
Now at Slumberland, all Beautyrests are on sale starting as low as $3.97. Slumberland, it's a good life.
Live captioning of KCCI News is brought to you by the Iowa Clinic.
When faced with a possible cancer diagnosis, you shouldn't have to wait for answers. The Iowa Clinic Women's Center believes in providing our patients peace of mind quickly. To schedule an appointment, call 875-9500.
The time is now 6:54.
And it's time for your news to go.
That's right. We are at the Des Moines Police Department this morning because they're looking to fill 26 vacant positions. They're looking for sworn officers. And they have their first academy class that's going to be graduating at the end of June. That's going to be 15 officers. That's going to help solve that problem. And then the next three cohorts of academy classes will be done in the next 12 months or so. That's all big news as the police department continues to step up and fill those gaps and even work overtime to meet the demand of this community.
Well, the Ottumwa Courier reports a man was arrested this week for sexual exploitation. Police say 26-year-old Anthony Gomez used a dating app to communicate with a 14-year-old girl, asking her to send him explicit photos. Take a good look at these new photos from Clive Police. They want to find these two women suspected of cashing stolen checks at a local bank. Police say the victim's purse was stolen and these women may have forged her checks. They were driving a silver Ford SUV.
Conflicting statements. President Trump is offering a different explanation for why he fired FBI Director James Comey. Our Nicole Killian's in Washington with that update.
President Trump told NBC News that he was planning to fire Director Comey all along.
Regardless of recommendation, I was going to fire Comey, knowing there was no good time to do it. And in fact, when I decided to just do it, I said to myself, I said, you know, this Russia thing with Trump and Russia is a made-up story.
The president contradicted days of explanations from the White House, which said the decision stemmed from a Justice Department memo citing Comey's missteps in the Clinton email probe. The president also insisted Comey told him he was not under investigation. That included a private dinner where Comey associates told the New York Times Comey declined to pledge his loyalty, but assured the president he'd always be honest. The White House disputed the Times report and said the president would never suggest the expectation of loyalty. In Washington, I'm Nicole Killian.
Well, last night, Stephen Colbert responded to President Trump's criticism of his show.
You see a no-talent guy like Colbert, there's nothing funny about what he says. The President of the United States has personally come after me and my show. And there's only one thing to say.
Colbert says he's been wanting Trump to say his name for the last year, so he wins. Colbert has top late night ratings across the country for 14 straight weeks.
A lot of people tuning in, yep, for sure. Well, we all love the looks of this weekend forecast. Yep.
Definitely, I think people are going to rate it a perfect 10, mm-hmm, because it's just going to be beautiful. Lots of sunshine out there. Ended up about 75 for today. There's your statewide forecast. Mid-70s for us. Again, enjoy the sun through the weekend. We continue that warming trend. Mother's Day, 85. 88 on Monday. Chance of storms into next week.
Good excuse to enjoy the weekend. We appreciate you spending your week with us. We're moments away from the eye opener on CBS this morning. Have a great Friday and happy Mother's Day, everybody.
This is Kristen. Hi. This is Caroline.
Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you.
Sorry, I'm just in a scramble because
our network went down. Oh. No, we don't have internet, so.
Network problem, you said?
Yeah, he's in IT.
I can at least look at it.
Why not? I'm here.
DHCP is not enabled. Okay.
That gateway is definitely different from that gateway.
Now I'm under pressure.
This is education for the real world. This is education working.
Jimmy Jones.
Se están comportando como monios.
Jimmy Jones. Ayúdame, por favor.
¿Cómo quieres que
pronto?
Jimmy John's, freaky fresh, freaky fast.
There's a reason why generation after generation people choose Stu Hanson first.
They just made me feel comfortable from the very beginning.
For generations, we've been creating customers for life.
I've been buying cars here at Stu's for years.
That's quite a history. Right now, it's our Drive and Discover event with 2017 Big Ram Quad Cabs for just $199 per month. At Stu's, we hear you.
I can't help it. They're just that good.
Up on the hill under the stars and stripes on Hickman.
Welcome to CBS This Morning. President Trump says he planned to fire James Comey no matter what. A source tells CBS News there is a crisis in the FBI. There is growing concern about the White House interfering with the Russia investigation.
An 8-year-old boy takes his own life after police say a bully knocked him unconscious at school. The boy's mother says the school claimed he fainted, but surveillance video tells a different story.
And dozens of great white sharks swarm the Southern California coast. We're in a helicopter over the threat that's forcing surfers out of the water.
But we begin this morning with a look at today's eye-opener. Your world in 90 seconds.
He's a showboat. He's a grandstander. The FBI has been in turmoil. You know that. I know that. Everybody knows that.
President Trump says he was going to fire Comey regardless.
That is not only inconsistent, it contradicts in every way what this White House said was the original impetus for the firing of James Comey.
Did this happen at 12:01 or 12:02? Did he fire him because he wore a red tie or a blue tie? This shouldn't be a complicated process.
I said, if it's possible, would you let me know, am I under investigation? He said, you are not under investigation.
It is just scandalously unethical, and I'm amazed that they think this is a defense for his actions.
What's your reaction to these bizarre conspiracies?
The message is resist, obstruct, deny, insult, insinuate.
Severe thunderstorms and damaging winds are moving over parts of the south into the northeast.
And then this becomes a chilly weekend rain climbing up through the mid-Atlantic.